Those who put themselves in harm's way for us, both here in this country and internationally. In my own name we pray.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Chairman, first of all, I would like to add, if the board will authorize it, a new item at the very end of the agenda. This would be agenda item 28, and this would be an agreement between Forsyth County and, I'm not sure I've got the party correctly identified, Carolan Properties as receiver for Eastbrook Properties. This would be an extension of their payment of their fine reduction award. This is something the board has already approved, but they were asking for an additional 2 weeks. So it's a fairly minor item. That will take, extension of time to pay. Yeah, we'll take a 4/5 to add it on, Mr. Chairman.
Second. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor? favor signify by saying aye. Aye. Those opposed, like sign. I believe that passes unanimously.
Was that the one with the people that were moving into the Bank of America? Had the receiver and all that?
No, this is another one. I'm pretty sure this is a different one. Yes, sir.
Other changes?
Mr. Chairman, with respect to the secondary metals ordinance or resolution, this was the one where you had requested at the meeting for the sheriff to come and speak to the boards. Can we postpone that to the next work session? That'll just take a simple majority.
Second. September 11th?
Let me find it. 16. Is it 16? Yes.
16.
Yes, sir. 16.
We have a motion. I'm sorry, do we have a second? We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, like sign. That passes unanimously.
Mr. Chairman, number four, my third request would be with respect to agenda item number three, board consideration of adding Assistant Solicitor General position. All I would ask here is simply that we change the title just so we've got a correct agenda for the record, and it would be adding Assistant Solicitor General position and accompanied administrative assistant. That's going to be the request made, but I think that's appropriate for purposes of accurately having the record on the agenda.
Second.
Do we want to move that to number one as well?
Ms. Abernathy is here. I'm sure she'd love to get back to her business.
I would appreciate that. Thank you.
Okay. Can we do this all in one motion, or do we need to approve it on?
It's fine. Do both.
Okay. Both things are on this motion. Seconded. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those like sign. What else, Ken?
Last is a question for the board, and that is does the board want to talk about the issue of just the city county water IGA? It's not on the agenda to the extent that we are talking about the invoices, but the actual IGA is not on the agenda. We're going to talk about that. Now is our time to add that to the agenda.
Well, I was thinking maybe we should have a special session about this Thursday, either a special call meeting Thursday. You shaking your head no?
No, that's fine. Of course that's fine. Yes, sir.
In fact, I would make a motion that we have a special call meeting, but I'd like to, I don't know what time.
That's 28th?
No, 3 o'clock. How's 3 o'clock look to everybody? Looks good to me. Tim Mary. And Tim Perkins. David Grumman. You're what?
I'll be waiting Thursday.
I can get with you ahead of time.
Sure.
And we can put
have
it down and write it. I'll get with you. Awesome. Some of the numbers that are.
He's telling just about to close my eyes.
Nothing here.
All right. Is there a motion? I made a motion to have a special called work session regarding water and between the county and the city in the form of an IGA Thursday the 30th at. Unless everybody has a problem with that.
3 o'clock.
We have a motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Okay, and that is a 4-0 with Commissioner Amos recused.
Thank you. The vote. That's all the items I had, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chairman, I would like to make a motion we postpone item 17, lost renegotiations for September 11th work session.
Which item?
17.
To 9-11.
To 9-11.
What? Can I ask why?
Basically, I'd just like to get some more information. I was out this week and I'd like to get more information.
What number was the
17?
17.
Is that to the 11th?
Yes, sir.
We have a motion. Do we have a second?
No doubt.
Would you second?
I'll second.
We have a motion, and we have a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye. Those like to move, that passes unanimously.
Mr. Chairman, just for purposes of just updating the board very quickly, we have pursuant to the board directive at the last regular session sent the notice to Mr. Mills asking for selection of mediators for law. So we are moving the ball forward.
Okay. Any other changes? If not, is there a motion to adopt the agenda as modified?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, like saying that's unanimous. Therefore, I have an announcement then based on, it may be a little redundant, but today we have a special call meeting at 5 p.m. for the purpose of discussing and considering a bond resolution for Forsyth County 2012 bond refinancing. If the work session is not finished by then, the work session meeting will be recessed for the purpose of entering into the special call meeting and will be reconvened at the close of the special call meeting. That's the announcement. All right. Item number one. Was they requesting Chief Bowman?
No, we did three.
That's right, three became one. Oh, that's right, it wasn't item one, it's an announcement. Oh.
Mr. Chairman, I'll take item number three, which has now become item number one. And obviously, forgive me, we're not doing that.
There's an announcement number one before you get into it.
Well, I was already on a tear. So
but it's not your name on it.
That's not.
What? Request by Chief
announcement number one.
By county attorney.
Fire station.
This county attorney.
Okay.
Chief. Well, let's let it take up.
Wait, did you tell me?
Yeah, mine's just county manager.
Can I just pass?
You want this?
I'd like to make an announcement.
What are we talking about?
At the September 11th, 2012 meeting, we're going to move from the table. Sawnee EMC agreement for electric service at fire station number 4. Place it on the September. I got a counselor.
Chief, are you happy with that?
County manager, right there.
Oh, there you is that what you wanted, Chief?
Yes.
Mine says county attorney.
Mine says county attorney.
Mine says
county
attorney.
Mine says county attorney.
I'm making an official record right now of what mine says.
Actually,
this is the one that matters.
Yeah, well.
This is the
I have.
Mine said county attorney junior.
Well, that would have been me. Thank you.
Okay, we have that announcement made. And now items for consideration and discussion. Well, item three has moved to item number one. Thank you, Chief.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Members of the board, thank you for allowing us to amend the agenda item on this as well. This is actually a request, and I will say this as candidly as I can make it. This is actually coming from not only my office, but also the Solicitor General's office, as well as the Chief Magistrate's office. I think it is fair to say we are all in lockstep with respect to the request that I'm about to place before you. And by way of history, just know that some years ago, and I cannot give you an exact date, it can be easily located, but some years ago, the magistrate had a request for there to be a prosecutorial representative in front of their courtroom. Makes very much a lot of sense. Not only are there civil cases in front of the magistrate court, but there are also criminal cases in front of the magistrate court. And at the time, the Board of Commissioners, for whatever reason, it wasn't this Board of Commissioners, it was the prior Board of Commissioners, was not of the mind to authorize an additional solicitor position to fill that prosecutorial role. And so, quite frankly, given my office's presence in code enforcement anyway, the thought was, well, let's just let the county attorney do it. The county attorney has the authority to do it under the pertinent statute. And so my office began to prosecute what we call mixed jurisdiction misdemeanor cases in front of the magistrate court. And that has gone on for some time. I will tell you that at the origin of that, when we were originally conceiving to do it, it was considered then to be temporary, and I have used this analogy for some time, sort of like the school trailer that gets pulled up. It's meant to be a temporary, and unfortunately it lasts a little longer than anyone had in mind. And I have gotten to the point, just with respect to how my practice is growing, I'm right now attempting to replace some positions, and I've always sort of had to have one foot in the water of a true criminal prosecutorial practice, and that has guided some of my hiring decisions and how I equip my office to be able to handle a very small sliver of what I do. And I am also just not of the position, of the opinion that I am able to manage that like I would like to be able to manage it. It's nothing I do. I don't do that. I don't prosecute criminally, nor do I have any criminal defense background experience. So in speaking with Leslie and speaking with Walker, the chief magistrate, we're all of the opinion that it might make sense right now. This would be a good time to perhaps transition this criminal prosecution role back to where it belongs, and quite frankly, where it's always belonged, and that is back to the Solicitor General's office. There are a whole host of reasons for that, not the least of which it provides continuity, a seamless transition between cases that move from magistrate court to state court. And quite frankly, it's what the Solicitor General does, and it's not what my office does. And so I'm coming to you today, and I think I speak on behalf of the Solicitor General, although she's obviously here and can tell you exactly what she feels. And of course, I did speak to the Chief Magistrate earlier today, and we are just kind of all three of us asking if the board, in its indulgence, would consider funding both an Assistant Solicitor General position as well as an administrative assistant to the Solicitor General's office to fulfill this role. I will still handle code enforcement prosecutions. I mean, I write a lot of the ordinances. It makes sense that I'm prosecuting those. I know them well. I'm happy to do that. I like doing it. I enjoy doing it. But with respect to these mixed jurisdictional criminal matters, truly criminal matters, I'm really to the point where I'm asking your indulgence and perhaps transitioning that to the agency, not the department, the agency where those belong.
So, Counselor, the real politique question to this is, how bad do you want to do this?
How bad? I really feel strongly about this. This is one of those transitions that just makes sense on so many different levels for a lot of different reasons.
I accept your argument. I was referring to financially, how bad.
You know, it's interesting. I mean, we have been able to do it for a relatively limited expense, but there are a lot of intangibles, quite frankly, that I think outweigh any sort of cost savings you might enjoy. And I don't suspect at the end of the day that the cost differential will be extraordinary by any stretch of the imagination. I mean, we have been billing you for this work, but it's not a large part of my practice. With the addition of the Solicitor General, not only could that person, I mean, again, I don't mean to speak for Leslie, but they could probably do this and then obviously meet some needs that the Solicitor General otherwise already has. So.
Do you concur?
Yes, I do. And previously in my 2013 budget submission, I had requested a new assistant solicitor and a new administrative assistant to go with that person. If you go ahead and make a mid-year budget adjustment and allow us to hire in those positions, we'll be able to easily assume this work and not have any additional increase that other than what was anticipated in 2013. And I do believe that this is the appropriate time to do it. It was meant as a band-aid. At the time, it seemed like a better management of cost. But at this time, it is no longer a tenable situation to have for us in the prosecution of these cases. It is going to be really sort of a wash at this point in terms of those costs. And with the increase anticipated in 2013, this is just a really good time to do it. Kim wants it done so bad that I have been to magistrate court twice already personally to handle these cases so that no one from his office had to go. And so we have already assumed those duties as of, I think it was August 7th, and started court there on August 9th. And we are managing that, but barely managing it. They have court for the concurrent jurisdiction cases every other Thursday, and on those dates, we typically also have state court criminal cases with Judge Smith, our chief judge, and those dates overlap and provides us with an inadequate staffing level for the long term to be able to cover those courtrooms. Also, with this request, I want to renew my request for your consideration on the reorg that we have put forth. Because having this new person and having them at a satellite location, a location off campus of the main courthouse where the administrators are, gives us challenges in supervision. And in order to maintain a professional prosecution at an off-site location, we need to have supervision. And what that means in my office is that we are able to have the staff where we can send someone to observe what they are doing in court, which we always do annually for evaluations anyway, but so that they're never in a position to be poorly supervised. And I think professionally that's very important. Ethically, it's mandated by the Georgia Bar that I am responsible for those that work for me and their professionalism and their ethics. And I do not feel comfortable having someone working off site, not very well supervised, and I believe the reorganization will address that. And right now in our budget, we have the budget savings in salary to cover that reorg from now to the end of the year, and we also have it in 2013. So it's not going to be a budget issue. I confirmed that right before stepping in here with finance.
What's the pleasure of the board?
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion to approve the adding of Assistant Solicitor General position and related administrative assistant position as presented by the county attorney and Assistant Solicitor. And you looked at the positions back, the finance and all that.
Well, the I can't speak regarding the finance.
I meant the finance side. She checked the finance.
I did. I met with Ms. Ream and finance right before I walked in here to confirm where we were currently in terms of budget savings for covering the reorganization aspect. In terms of hiring in the new people at the midpoint, which would be my request, that would take a mid-year budget adjustment to cover that cost.
Do you
need to add that to my motion?
Well, we would need the dollar amount.
I have the dollar amount.
Oh, good. Because I don't have it.
Let me just withdraw that motion.
Yes, sir.
And it's time sensitive necessary because we're trying to do a midterm.
Yes,
it would be
yes,
preferred.
Yeah. I can only do that so long myself. And right now, that is what it is just me rather than reading these out in this.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. I believe that passes unanimously. Now we are to what have been item number one, I believe, which is a review of the request by the Grand Cascades Community Association. Are any of the folks from Grand Cascades here? Yeah. Does anybody have the email? From Chris Faulkner.
You got it?
In the book, okay, thank you.